Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you, sir?
Nice. What about you?
Fine, sir.
How are you, father? Who is here? Says Abdul Jaleel, how are you? Ibrahim, how are you?
Prepared.
Everybody?
We are ready for test.
Sir, nice, sir. How?
Okay. Just we have to revise. Okay. Yesterday lesson, your self-introduction and interview. After a few minutes, I have to start your test. Yeah, you have to refresh.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Okay, good. I was talking about it that today is test day, and you can take 2 or 3 minutes. Then after sharp 4 p.m. class will start, your test will start one by one. Regarding Pakistan, I have to do a test about Pakistan and self-introduction or an interview. First language test, a very important test for you. Okay, let me start test. You are conscious about it, today is test day. I think that you prepared well your test. So I have to take start from Abdul Jaleel. I want to tell you about one thing, that there are 2 parts of test. First of all, I will ask you question answers, first part. And second part is presentation. There are 2 parts of test. First of all, question answers. And the other part is about presentation for two or three minutes. Yes, as soon as I talked about Abdul Jaleel, so he disappeared.
Yes, sir.
So it looks like, I think so. Looks like now he felt fear like a lion, that lion came in front of him. Let us start from Hamza. Are you ready, Hamza?
Sir, I'm ready, sir.
That's good.
I will give you
problems. It is very important that if we want overcome the problem, so we have to face the problem, then problems can solve. A good thing. Yes, let I start. First of all, I will ask you 5 questions and you have to reply me according to my question. Hamza.
Okay, sir. Okay, I'm ready, sir.
That's good. Okay. Would you like to tell me about that what happened in 1857 in the subcontinent?
Yes, sir. Can you repeat, sir?
I have to repeat my question.
Yes, sir.
What happened in 1857 in the subcontinent?
The British government came into the subcontinent in the...
Okay.
In the for trading, sir, and they fought and they hold on the subcontinent.
Okay.
Indians, Hindus and Muslims, they both fought for their freedom in 1857.
Right. I ask you next question. But, I ask you next question. What happened in 1979 in Pakistan?
Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was hanged up in a fake murder case.
Right. I ask you next question. How many colors of flag of Pakistan?
There are two color of flag of Pakistan. The white color represent minority of Pakistan and the green color represent majority of Pakistan.
Okay. What do you mean by Muslim. Moon and star on the flag of Pakistan?
Moon means prosperity. Star means success.
Okay, right. Question number four I ask you. You have to tell me about what was the old capital of Pakistan.
The old capital of Pakistan was Karachi.
Okay, right. Quite right. You have to tell me now that why Muslims hated from English language in the subcontinent.
Yes, sir. Muslim hated English language because of the negative role of a British government. They were not giving their jobs for Muslims and other issues also.
Okay. Your test is completed now, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, next one, who is here? Yes. Yes, Kainat, I ask you. I'll ask you five
questions. Yes, sir.
Okay. And as usual, you know, as I told you before some time that I have to ask five questions. First of all, I ask you, you have to tell me what were major differences between Hindu and Muslim nations?
Muslim and Hindu are different nations because Hindu and Hindu and different culture and Pakistan as different culture as different dressing, different religions, different religions, different in dressing, different in culture.
Okay.
Different in language.
Okay. It means there were, you want to say that there were many differences between Hindus and Muslims.
Yeah.
Okay, I ask you next question. You have to tell me that what happened in 1951 in Pakistan?
Yes, sir. Dobara bolen. Sir, repeat the question.
I will cut your mouth. You spoke Urdu in the class. I will cut your mouth, okay?
Okay, sir.
So you lost 5 marks. Okay. So I ask, repeat my question. That what happened in 1951 in Pakistan?
1951. Liaquat Ali Khan as the first Prime Minister of Pakistan in
Okay.
Liaquat Ali Khan was the first Prime Minister of Pakistan and Balga.
Okay. I ask you next question. Question number three. Sir. You have to tell me that why Hindus learned English language. Why?
Because he had good jobs. and poverty of and national poverty of British. Good of jobs, had good of jobs and poverty of nationality.
Okay. Question number four, I ask you.
Yes, sir.
You have to tell me now what happened in
1948. Two terrorists, 1948, two terrorists, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah died in 11th September on 1948, and second, we have lost in Kashmir.
Okay. Your question completed? I think so. Five questions completed. Completed your five questions?
Yes. Sir.
What happened?
Prime Minister, sir, one left.
Okay, are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I ask you last question. You tell me what happened in
1974.
What happened?
Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto had a fake murder case.
Okay. Now, who is ready? Okay, let's complete now. Next one.
Yes, sir. Ibra.
Not Bilal Khan. Bilal Khan.
Yes, sir.
I ask you a question. Yes, I ask you five questions.
But yes, sir.
First of all, you tell me that what happened in 1992?
What happened in 1992, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, the East Pakistan was separated in 1992.
Okay. Next question I ask you. You have to tell me that who was Arfa Karim, who was she?
What, sir?
Who was Arfa Karim? Who was she?
Sir, Arfa Karim was a Pakistani girl software maker. She made a software and her name was written in Guinness Book of World Record.
Oh.
And she died in 2012.
Right. Question number three. Question number three. You tell me that what happened? What happened in 2005?
In 2005, major earthquake came in Pakistan, and a lot of people, mostly people, were died at that earthquake.
Okay. Question number four.
Yes.
You tell me that what happened in 1998, sir?
Yeah.
Sorry, sir. Okay. Okay. Mic. Thank you. Yes, Bilal.
Yes, sir.
What happened in 1998?
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Last question I ask you. Yes. You tell me that what happened in 1979.
Sir, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was hanged up in the fake murder case.
Okay, right. Your five questions completed now. Next, now, Ibrahim, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I ask you first question. You tell me that what did Sir Syed Ahmed Khan for Muslims in the subcontinent?
Sir, Sayyid Ahmad Khan told to Muslim that you can learn English by all means, then you can get success, then you can get jobs, because the Muslim people hated from English British rulers and also hated from English language. So they write many books and they open Aligarh College and University for Muslim.
Okay. Next question I ask you. Next question. You tell me that what happened in happened on 8th October 2005.
On 8th October 2005, earthquake in Pakistan and a lot of people were dying.
Okay. Okay. Next question I ask you. How many questions I ask you? Three questions I ask you? Abrar?
Sir, two questions.
Question three now. You tell us what happened in 1965.
In 1965, Pakistan defeated India. War took place in 1965 and Pakistan win the war.
Okay. Question number four. You tell us about what was the base of Pakistan?
The base of Pakistan is Kalma.
Okay, right. Last question I ask you. There were two reasons behind Pakistan made. What were two main reasons?
Sir, two nation theory.
Okay, first reason. What is the second reason?
Sir, Muslim want to.
Yes.
Sir, Muslim want to live other separate country. Want to separate country. They cannot live with Hindus.
Okay. You have five questions completed now. Okay. Next, who is there? Okay. I think not for the students are there. So I have to inform about your result. Then, so second part, okay, about presentations. Total marks are 50 now, and total marks. I have to start presentations. Test of presentations. Total marks 50. I give you 2 or 3 minutes. You can refresh up all things. Presentation is different thing. You have to speak continuously for 3 minutes. I give you 3 minutes. Let you can fresh up all things in your mind now.
Sir, Jaleel came.
Jaleel came. Where you were, Jaleel? What is problem?
Sir, there are problem for internet.
Oh my God. Okay, so you have to also appear in the test now. First part regarding question answers. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Pakistan. So I will ask you 5 questions, and then other part. Okay, of test presentations.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I ask you first question. You tell me that anything was common in Hindus and Muslims in the subcontinent?
Yes, sir.
What was common in Hindus and Muslims in the subcontinent? Anything was common there? in two nations?
Sir,
I ask you next question.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You tell me that in the subcontinent, why Muslims got prosperity? What was the reason behind? What was the main reason behind Muslims got prosperity in the subcontinent? You tell me now. Muslims were victim of poverty in the subcontinent. But okay, next question I ask you.
Yes, sir.
You okay. Tell me about it. Who was Malala Yousafzai? Who was she? What she did for Pakistan? Question number four.
Sir, Malala is a,
okay.
Sir, Malala is a Pakistan activist for female education and the youngest Nobel Prizer.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. I ask you next question. Why Pakistan is important for us as a Pakistani?
Sir, no, sir.
Don't know?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the major and basic problem in Pakistan? Don't know?
Sir, Pakistan are the problems, poverty, sir, energy crisis, corruption, and political and international interference, terrorism, overpopulation implication. Yes.
Okay. 5% class complete now.
Okay.
Other part. Okay, any student left now? All students okay, completed the test first phase of test? Yes, certainly. Okay, after, you know, 3 minutes, we have to start, test of presentations. Just you can flash up all things in your mind now, let it now. Maybe self, you also, I can ask you about self-introduction, also about interview, and also I can say you that you have to start presentation on Pakistan. You have to flash up all things, just you have 3 minutes. Everybody. Okay, let I start other part of test. First of all, Bilal.
Yes, sir.
You have to start presentation on Pakistan just for 3 minutes. Let us start now.
Presentation, sir, I should end.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Pakistan is a Muslim country which was based on Kalma. And Pakistan was came into being in 1947, 14th August 1947. And Pakistan flag have two colors, green and white. The green color means the majority in Pakistan, and the white color means minorities in Pakistan. And sir, Pakistan is a Muslim country. Pakistan is underdeveloped country. There are a lot of problems in Pakistan. The major problem in Pakistan is illiteracy, that mostly people are uneducated due to poverty, and because of mostly people of 70% of people of Pakistan are living in tribal areas, and there are no any schools and universities to educate them. And secondly, there is a big problem of hospitals, that we don't have good and big hospitals. Only in cities we have hospitals. In the village, there is no any availability of doctors and hospitals. And the major problem is that our leaders are corrupt. They don't think about Pakistan, that they are making our country in loss. They just do corruption for themselves and make money for themselves. They don't think about Pakistan. And my suggestions for Pakistan, that firstly, we should educate our Pakistani people who are living in tribal areas and can't afford good education. And we should make hospitals. And
okay, time is over. Okay, next. Yes, Ibrar.
Yes, sir. Pakistan.
Let us start your presentation on Pakistan just for 3 minutes. Let's start now.
Okay, sir. Pakistan is a Muslim country. Pakistan based on Kalma. Pakistan, the national language of Pakistan is Urdu. The national dress of Pakistan is Shalwar Kameez. And there are four provinces in Pakistan. There are four seasons in Pakistan. The flag of Pakistan, there were two colors there, and with moon and stars. Green color was majority in Pakistan, and white colors means minority in Pakistan. The moon means brightness, and the star means success. And Pakistan importance. Pakistan is very important for us because we can move easily and go easily anywhere. This we can say our prayers, we can recite Quran, nobody can stop us, we can get job in Pakistan. There is a lot of importance of Pakistan and background of Pakistan. Muslim were ruled many centuries in Pakistan. After in 1857, when British ruler came in subcontinent, the last ruler, Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar, left subcontinent, and British rulers ruled in subcontinent, and Muslim were get job easily. Indians cooperated with British rulers, and they can learn English language, and they can get success, and they can get job easily. At that time, Muslim not learn English, then they can hated from British rulers because Muslim were ruled for many centuries. At that time, Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan told to Muslim that you can learn English by all means, and you can, when you can get success, you can, that is compulsory for you, that you can learn English You can hate it from British rulers, but you cannot hate it from British language. So they can
stop.
They can.
Okay, time's completed now. Next, Jaleel.
Abdul, yes, Jaleel. Sir.
You have to start, sir, your self-introduction for 3 minutes.
Pakistan. Sir, sir, Pakistan. Pakistan,
no, no.
Self-introduction?
No, 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 no. Your self-introduction.
Your self-introduction?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, my name is Abdul Jaleel and my father's name is Hazrat Shah, and my qualification for the mutual and residence Islamabad G94 Shower Mode and village city Kuitpulistan, Quetta Job. In my hallway, football, visiting and traveling, and my future educate Supreme Court of Pakistan.
Okay. Now, yes, just for, you know, just for 1 minute, you have to start presentation on Pakistan, just for 1 minute.
Yes, sir. Sir, Pakistan is a Muslim country located in Southern Asia. The neighboring countries are India, Iran, Afghanistan, and China. It is officially called the Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Sir, the struggle of Pakistan was started when the Muslim of subcontinent got harassed by the Indian government and was not getting their proper rights. Pakistan leader Sir Syed Ahmad Khan firstly used the word nation of the Muslim after his two nation theory, and Allama Iqbal taught about a separated state in which Islam Muslim can live according to Muslim teaching. Pakistan has 4 provinces, 2 territories and 2 special areas. The special areas are enough. Kashmir.
Time is over. Okay. Next one.
Alaka told the Katua will be, huh?
Yes. Next now, Kainat.
Yes, sir.
You have to start, okay, presentation on Pakistan. Let us start now. For 3 minutes.
Okay, sir. Pakistan is a Muslim country. Pakistan independent on 14 August in 1947. Pakistan made based of Kalma. Qaid-e-Azam is the founder of Pakistan. Lakhat Khan, the first Prime Minister of Pakistan. Its national language of Pakistan is of Urdu. Pakistan, the national dress of shalwar kameez, shalwar suits. Pakistan has 4 seasons. All capital of Pakistan is Karachi, and latest capital of Pakistan in Islamabad. Pakistan has 4 seasons. There are 2 colors of flag. Pakistan green color shows the Muslim majority in Pakistan. White color shows the region minorities. There are also moon and star flags of Pakistan. Moon means prosperity, and the star means success.
How many mics are on now? Abdul Jaleel, your mic is on. Now, it's not good thing that you have to keep on your mic during test. Not a good thing. Yes?
Why Pakistan important for us? We born in Pakistan. We got early education in Pakistan. We do job in Pakistan. We do in business in Pakistan. We have freedom in Pakistan. There are many problems of Pakistan because we have underdeveloped country. Pakistan is a poor country. First of all, Pakistan is an illiteracy country. Many people are uneducated in Pakistan because large number of Pakistan in people living in village. The 70% of live in the.
Okay. Your time is over now. Yet now, who's join the class, Hussain? Hussain, how are you?
Sir, fine.
Okay, you joined too late class today. What happened?
Sir, the guests are coming.
Okay. Are you ready for test?
Yes, sir.
I will ask you 5 questions. Then you have to start. Okay. After test, question answered, you have to start a presentation on Pakistan for 3 minutes. First question I ask you, you have to tell me who was the first Prime Minister of Pakistan.
Sir, the first Prime Minister of Pakistan was Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah.
Okay. Next question I ask you. You tell me that what is that, in which year first Prime Minister was killed? In which year first Prime Minister of Pakistan was killed?
Sir, 1979.
Okay. I ask you next question. You tell me that what happened in 1857 in the subcontinent?
Sir, 1857?
Yeah.
Sir, sorry.
Okay. Question number 4. You tell me that what happened in 1971 in Pakistan?
Sir, 1971.
Don't know?
Sir, I don't know.
Okay, last question I ask you. You tell me, who is Imran Khan?
Sir, Imran Khan is the Prime Minister. Sir, Imran Khan is Prime Minister of Pakistan.
Okay. Yet you start. Yes?
Yes, sir.
I ask you presentation. You have to speak for 3 minutes on Pakistan. Let us start now.
Pakistan independent on 14 August 1947. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was the founder of Pakistan. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was first Governor General of Pakistan. There are many sacrifices to making Pakistan. There are very villages and towns in Pakistan. Sir, the Islamabad is the capital of Pakistan. Karachi is the largest city of Pakistan. Karachi is the largest city of Pakistan. Sir, bus.
Finish. Oh, you yes, spoke sir. Urdu. I will cut your one mark. You spoke Urdu. Okay?
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Yes, also your mother is there?
No, sir.
In test? Okay. Now, you know that I asked from everybody. Yes. Now, time of result now. Hussein got 20 marks out of 50. Hamza, 42 marks. Kainat, 40 marks. Abrar, 40 Mars. Bilal. And Jaleel. Mars. Is that in front of you? Bilal got first position. Hamza got second position. Kainat got third position. Abrar got third position. And Jaleel passed. And Hussain could not get the success. In the next test, Hussain can get success. No problem. It's a part of life. Now, first of all, I appreciate to Bilal. Well done. You got first position.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. You keep keep it up, your struggle. In every test, you have to get first position, okay? You have to maintain your position.
Inshallah, sir.
Hamza is available. Okay, I think not. Anyway, you can inform him about his result. Hamza got 42 marks. He got second position. Very good. And Kainat and Abrar got third position. Good. Kainat and Abrar.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Kainat. Yes, Kainat. Do you listen? So, I want to tell you one thing. Actual thing is that I tell you about these things. First of all, I told you that you have to speak English. You don't care about you have to speak English wrong, correct or incorrect. But I told you that if you have to speak Urdu in this class, I will cut the marks. So I cut the marks of some students. On the other hand, you know that if you have to reply me wrong, instead of you have to speak English, but I don't care about here correct or incorrect, but you have to speak, but question is wrong, so I will cut the marks. Keep in mind these things. For second test, keep in mind these things, that you have to speak English, the correct or incorrect, but you have to speak. But you have to take care about tenses. What tense you have to use, you should take care about it now. It will, you know, you have to learn these things after some time. But you have to, okay, speak English continuously in your routine life. You have to speak English. You have to make it your habit that you have to speak English. At least you have to use vocabulary in your conversation if you talk to somebody. As I told you many times, and I told you again today, you have to prefer three tenses in your conversation, in your talking. As I told you last time, so I tell you again today. If you talk about present, then you have to prefer present definite tense. If you have to talk about past, then you have to prefer past definite tense. If you have to talk about future, then you have to prefer future definite tense. But instead of, I tell you one thing, that just by practice, you can improve your mistakes and you can improve well. You can improve you. You can improve yourself well. And you have to listen BBC. You have to listen CNN. Make it your habit. And in language, I tell you one thing, very important point. You have to understand sense. Language. If you have to listen BBC and CNN, just you have to understand the sense of news. it is impossible for you. You have to try to understand everything. No, in language, just you have to understand the sense. You have to understand the sense. How you can improve your sense now? You have to improve your vocabulary. Now, your language started now. In every briefing, you have to get new vocabulary. Instead of you have lost vocabulary. As I told you that in your conversation, you can make short sentences by help of three tenses, as I described you, like present definite tense, past definite tense, and future indefinite tense. So I am much happy that in the first language test, four students got position. I appreciate you. And in coming test, I expect that everybody have to get position in the class. How it is possible? Just by struggle. No way. Accept it now. And you have to talk with yourself all the time. The best way of practice, you have to talk with yourself. You have to engage your mind in free time. You have to make sentences, short sentences. And you can practice in this way. There are different methods of practice. If you're, you know, I talk about, you can watch the English movies and you can improve your English. You have to improve your listening skill, first of all. Then you have to, by, you know, speaking, you have to improve your spoken skill. If you get command on these two things, listening skill, you have to improve your listening skill and spoken skill. I give you a guarantee that you can perform well in your future. And I advise you, as I advised you last time, three to four times I advised it about it. You have to speak English slow. Don't try to speak English rapidly, quickly, or fastly. In near future, I will note these things now. I have to check your pronunciation. Second to third test, I will check it, your pronunciation. And if you can control and you can improve your pronunciation, if you have to act on my instructions, you have to improve your listening skill and you have to improve your spoken skill. How can, if you have to speak slow, how you can improve your pronunciation? If you have to speak slow, if you try to speak rapidly, quickly, or fastly, most probably you will speak quite wrong instead of your sentence is right. But due to wrong pronunciation, your sentence will be wrong. Keep in your mind these things. From language point of view, I'm talking from language point of view. These are very precious instructions and directions for you. It depends on you that how much you act on my instructions. Good start. You took good start in language. I appreciate to all of you. But I keep in mind these things. Failures and successes are part of life. Sometimes you have to get few marks, some marks, but by struggle, next time you have to get extraordinary marks just by struggle. Everybody should be positive minded, not negative minded. If you want to get success, you have to make positive minded. Keep in mind this thing. I have not, you know, that any clash with any student. I trust on merit. And your recommendation is your ability. Keep in mind this thing. Your ability will recommend you, and it is your recommendation. Your ability is your recommendation, and nobody can stop you from success. I am well wisher of you. I wanted that everybody have to get first position in this class. It is my dream. And I am much hopeful that this class will make record and everybody have to get first position in this class in language test now. And even in final test. Then you have to complete this course. Your success is my success. Keep in mind this thing. Your success is my success. Your victory is my victory. Just you have to listen my instructions and directions, and you have to cooperate with me. Inshallah, you have to get success. That time is not so far. Why we have to speak Urdu easily? Why we have to speak easily other languages? Because we have to speak. It's the main reason behind now. If we have to speak, so we can speak easily. Same here. If you have to speak English language easily by practice, you can speak well in short time. You can talk with yourself all times. You can question answers from yourself, and you can reply from your mind. It is also a method, best way of practice. You have to talk with your soul. You have to talk with you, okay, with yourself. You have to make questions in your mind, and then according to that, according to questions, you have to reply. There are different methods of practice. Do you have any question regarding today's test? So you can ask me. If you don't understand my lecture, my briefing, my instructions, my directions, so you can ask me, sir, please repeat it. So I will repeat. Yes, anyone?
Sir, you told me that what is the two...
I didn't understand what you said now. What two?
Hello, sir.
What you said? Repeat your question. Yeah, your question.
Sir, you told me that what is the two reasons behind the making of Pakistan? Question you asked me.
Briefing?
Yes, sir.
Briefing, I gave you briefing, okay, in last class now for 40 to 45 minutes. Presentation. Yo, there is difference between briefing and presentation. Presentation means it is short. Presentation is short. But briefing means lecture. It is different between briefing and presentation. Yes, Ibrar?
Sir.
Yes, anyone? Further, any question? Yes, Jaleel, Bilal, Kainat, and yes, Ibrar asked question. He asked me. No problem. Some students are not in the class today. Where is Asmat today, Jaleel? Asmat, where disappeared? Jaleel? Where is Asmat? He left us, I think so.
Yes, sir.
He left us?
No, sir.
Where is Asmat nowadays?
Sir, I don't know, sir.
Okay. I think he's your cousin, so I asked you.
Yes.
Right. So I gave you instructions, and I am much hopeful, and I expect from you that you will show, as you know, students got positions, and other students also will get position in the next test most probably, and I tell you one thing, that tomorrow is off. A very important message I want to tell you, that from 1st January in 2020, inshallah, offline classes will start. You have to come to academy, everybody, from 1st January, okay? Did you understand what I
yes,
said?
Yes, sir.
Yes, from 1st January,
yes,
no online class. I will not take your online class. You have to come to academy in time, sharp 4 p.m. After you start, everybody have to come to academy on 1st January 2021. Okay? Very important message for you.
Yes, sir.
If you students don't come today, so you can inform them that from 1st January 2021, everybody have to come to academy and your offline classes will start. You have to come in the class to academy. So inshallah, I will start new briefing day after tomorrow. I mean to say on Monday. I will start new briefing. Most probably, I think on habits. Okay. I noted you all syllabus of this class. Yes, Ibrat?
Okay, sir.
You have all syllabus in your record. I noted you syllabus regarding language class. So I think class should go to end now. We have to meet again on Monday. Wish you good luck.
Yes, sir. Thanks.
Allah.
Thank you.
Welcome.